This is Queen Elizabeth National Park on a typical day. If you are lucky, animals come to you at the Katunguru Reservation office just before you set off into the depths of the conservation area, which covers 1,978 square kilometers. The park is known for the tree-climbing lion, warthog, Ugandan cob, and African elephant among its abundant wildlife. But this popular tourist destination in western Uganda was the scene of the killing of two foreign visitors and their Ugandan guide.
The security is normal. All activities are actually going very normally. We have the tourists here.
South African Nadra and her husband Omar from Kenya arrived on Monday, a day before the murders. They were fearful when they heard about the killings, but continued with their journey to the park. They didn't want to appear on camera, but were comfortable enough with an audio interview during their stopover at Katunguru.
Obviously, it was very shocking when we heard what happened, and it is quite scary because we're also tourists, and it was a random sort of attack where people lost their lives. But everywhere we've been since then, even in Kibale, there was an increased police and security presence. So that does reassure us. And we have heard that the government is taking it very seriously. So that is good news. And I mean, I hope that it doesn't affect the tourism of this country further.
Yeah, so far I think we've had a great time in Uganda. It's a very, very beautiful country. We're very much looking forward to going to Bwindi and to visit the mountain gorillas.
Police is reassuring all Ugandans and visitors that the safety of tourists is a priority. Queen Elizabeth National Park is 410 kilometers from the capital city. To tour, one pays 20,000 shillings and foreigners part with $40. Despite the heinous acts last week, the park is recording an increase in the number of visitors.
First of all, these are people who had booked, but also we have reassured the public. We have reassured the world that Uganda is safe, Queen Elizabeth is safe, and most of the people who know that park, they know that the road where the incident happened is a public road, and as such, it is not one of the tourism roads inside the park where people go to do tourism activities. So they feel a sense of safety under our care while inside the park.
It's after crossing the Kazinga Channel, about 40 kilometers to Kasese Town, that a junction leads to Katwe Sanctuary. British David Jim Barlow, 50, South African Emeritia Celia Geya, 51, and Ugandan Eric Aliai, 40, were killed at Nyamunuka on Katwe Road on October 17th. By asylum suspected to be linked to rebel outfit Allied Democratic Forces. Their bodies are at the Mulago National Referral Hospital mortuary in Kampala. The police spokesperson Fred Enanga says forensic teams from the United Kingdom and South Africa are set to re-examine the bodies of their citizens. Barlow and Gaya were a couple on honeymoon.
How much UWA can do in terms of guaranteeing security for tourists on a public road, which is inside the national park?
That was the small gap which we with the military have already kind of addressed, because we have had a number of meetings since yesterday, and out of these meetings all this have been sorted out.
President Yoweri Museveni reassured the country of security on Saturday as he announced another attack on an ADF camp. There's integrated highway patrol along major roads and highways in and around Kasese district, and security deployments are beefed up at all tourist sites. Razia Athman, reporting for the news.